Today I want to talk about the CSS property box sizing. Box sizing solves a problem that's been making front-end development more confusing for years. The problem is when you add padding and borders to your layouts, the layouts will often break, or just in general cause things to look different than you expected. Here's an example in my demo. I have three columns in my layout that are all 30% wide. The margins on the left and right are each 1.66%. If you do the math, the total width is 99.96%, or almost 100%. We'll get to these columns in a moment. I also have a footer at the bottom. The footer has a width of 300 pixels. If I add padding to the footer, see how it grows? It doesn't break anything here, but the width of the footer is no longer 300 pixels. It's now 340 pixels because the padding is added to the width of the box. If I really want the width to be 300 pixels, I need to subtract 40 from the width that I specify. I did this kind of thing for years, and it was really annoying. Today, web layouts are more responsive and fluid, and we use percentages more often when specifying our widths. Trying to subtract out your padding and borders, which might be specified in pixels or ms instead of percentages, makes what was just annoying in a fixed-width layout even more difficult to deal with today. Let's see what happens when we add padding to our columns. As soon as I add the padding, the layout breaks. That's because the 1m of padding is added to the column's width. So the width of each column is 30% plus 1m. I'm not sure how many pixels each column is in this current layout because 30% is dependent on the browser's viewport. But even if I make my viewport larger, the layout will still break. Adding any pixels to the total width will make the entire thing greater than the 100% that I'm going for here. Even removing the padding and adding something as small as a 1 pixel border around each box also breaks the layout. The solution to this dilemma is to use the box sizing property. We can see that there are 4 values possible for box sizing. Border box is the one that we want. When I add it, the layout is fixed and the boxes all fit in one line again. What border box does is change the box model so that border and padding are included inside of the width that you specify on the element. So the total width will be 30% regardless of what the padding and border sizes are. The default is content box, and that makes the box model work the way we're used to, the way that we don't like and that drives us crazy because it breaks things when you add padding and borders. The padding and borders are added to the total width, making things larger than you want. There are 2 other options for box sizing property that you probably won't use. Inherit just means the value will be inherited from the parent element if it's specified. Padding box doesn't really work anywhere right now, so I wouldn't think of it as a valid option. Just focus on remembering border box as the solution that you want to use. We can see if I put my footer back to 300 pixels and then I remove the padding, the box stays the same size regardless of the padding. So border box is the setting that makes the box model work the way you intuitively would think it should work. According to the MDM reference, this is an experimental technology, meaning the technology is not completely stable in all browsers. But this is a little misleading. Really, the experimental part of this is the padding box value. If you look at the compatibility table, you can see that this really has excellent support. You can use it with IE8 and above and all other major browsers. You can see from the table that the prefixless version is acceptable in all the latest versions of the browsers now, except for Firefox. You'll be able to use the prefixless version with Firefox 29, which is due to be released soon. So if you're watching this video after April of 2014, you may decide you don't want to use prefixes at all. It's pretty well accepted today that you can use this snippet towards the beginning of your CSS to reset the box sizing model on all elements. The Bootstrap framework and I believe the Foundation framework both use this snippet towards the beginning of their code. So if you're using a framework of some sort, you probably don't need or want to add it yourself. But if you're rolling your own, it would be a good idea to add it at the end of any reset that you might be using. The one caveat is that sometimes it doesn't play nicely with some third-party plugins. So you might need to override those elements to go back to content box individually. Otherwise, using this snippet should serve you well in your CSS development.